the name of Jesus. This is Evangelist Brenda Thompson coming to you today. Today I greet you in no other name than in Jesus' mighty name. The title of my message today is The Offer of Eternal Salvation. My message is taken from Hebrews chapter 5 verse 1 to 10, and my reference is Hebrews chapter 2 and verse 10. For every high priest taken from among men is ordained for men in things pertaining God, that he may offer both gifts and sacrifices for sins. Who can have compassion on the ignorant and on them that are out of the way, for that he himself also is compassed with infirmity? And by reason hereof he ought as for the people, so also for himself to offer for sins. And no man taketh this honor unto himself, but he that is called of God, as was Aaron. So as Christ glorified not himself to be made a high priest, but he that said unto him, Thou art my son, today have I begotten thee. As he said also in another place, Thou art a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek, who in the days of his flesh, when he had offered up prayers and supplication with strong crying and tears unto him that was able to save him from death, and was heard in that he feared. Though he were a son, yet learned he obedience by the things which he suffered. And being made perfect, he became the author of eternal salvation unto all them that obey him. Called of God, a high priest, after the order of Melchizedek. Please turn with me to Hebrews chapter 2 and verse 10. For it became him for whom are all things, and by whom are all things, in bringing many sons unto glory, to make the captain of their salvation perfect through suffering. Father, I come to you today in no other name, hallelujah, but in the glorious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let this message, oh God, be a blessing. Let it bring deliverance and healing to some soul today. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Today I would like to draw your attention to verse 9. And being made perfect, he became the author of eternal salvation unto all them that obey. One who is the author of our eternal salvation. In verse 1 to 10, the writer tells us in verse 1 to 4 the three specific qualifications of the Levitical priesthood. One, he must minister on behalf of the people by offering sacrifices for sin. Two, he must have on all those who have sinned because of ignorance or lack of accurate knowledge. And truly, he must be called of God. In verse 5 to 10, Jesus Christ meets all these requirements as it's being demonstrated by the author. Not only did Jesus Christ meet all these requirements, but Jesus reversed the order of the priesthood by showing his divine appointment in verse 5 and 6. So also Christ glorified not himself to be made a high priest, but he that said unto him, Thou art my son, today have I begotten thee. As he said also in another place, Thou art a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. Praise the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. In verse 7 and 8 demonstrates Jesus' compassion by the experience in the Garden of Gethsemane. You can find that reference in Mark chapter 14 and verse 32 to 42, and in verses 9 and 10 of Hebrews chapter 5 demonstrates Jesus becoming the perfect offering for sin. And this is what makes Jesus the only offer of our eternal salvation. Who is this Jesus? He is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He is the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. There is no end to him because he is eternal. Today, I would like to conclude on the offer of the eternal salvation with a prayer for salvation for those who do not know this Jesus as Lord and Savior. I would like to pray a prayer for hope, a prayer for healing, a prayer for marriages and family, a prayer for deliverance from all demonic activities and all demonic presence. I would like to pray a prayer for prosperity, peace, and a prayer for joy. Father, I come to you today in Jesus' mighty name. I pray a prayer of salvation for all those who need salvation. I pray a prayer of hope for the hopeless. I pray a prayer of healing for those who are sick and suffering today. I pray a prayer for marriages that are on the verge or the brink. Hallelujah. Of Lord deterioration today. I pray, for families that need strength and unity. I pray, for deliverance from all demonic activity. I pray against all principality and against all witches and witchcraft today, and every demonic spell today. I pray, for prosperity, peace, and joy. I ask all his mercies today, in order name, and in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.